Happy St. Patrick's Day to everyone out there today. Rich Wildman here, Music Scene Investigation. Glad you joined us. Pew, pew, Barney McGrew, Cuthbert, Dibble, and Grub. I was told that was cool to say. I don't believe you, Ian. Not a bit.
You've just hit a cult English market there, Rich.
Did I? Now, can we put that in our tags for the show so that everybody who knows that, looking it up, will hit our show instead of the original video or whatever?
We could try. We could try. See what happens.
All right. We'll do that then. Appreciate you tuning in on St. Patrick's Day all over the world. In some places, it's tomorrow, which really technically, well, it's not St. Patrick's Day there, but it is here, and we're glad to have you with us. Music Scene Investigation, for those who aren't familiar with the show, is where we put three songs from independent artists in front of our expert panel, get them to review that song after hearing it one time. So they don't have the luxury of listening to it thousands of times or tens of times prior to offering up their review. They don't even know who it's by, the name of the song, the genre it's in, or anything like that. They get it, listen to it one time, and then offer their quick review, usually a technical review, about that track. Now, I want to introduce our panelists to you before we get into the music, and we'll start with Ian Husbands over in London, since he's closer to Ireland than any place else. Ian, how are you today?
Wales is technically closer, and France probably is as well. Not that we'd like to admit that. But, happy St. Patrick's Day to all my Irish friends and colleagues and other such people.
Well, we're glad you're with us. Did you celebrate St. Patrick's Day at all?
Nope.
Not a bit, huh?
No, not really. I have no Irish or direct Irish descendants. I'm sure somewhere down the husband's history there is an Irish person or two, but I have no real allegiance. I'm English, and that's the way it's gonna stay, baby.
All right, all right. I'm not trying to push you into changing.
That's, you know, just making sure, you know.
As
you
the
know,
song Saint, says, don't go changing.
You know, St. George, that patron saint of England who was Syrian.
We'll leave it at that.
Just saying.
Yeah, we'll leave it at that. Now, out in the chat room, Carol is saying that today is her husband's and her son's birthday. Happy birthday to them. And she is saying that the Reardons are Irish.
You could have kind of guessed that, really.
So happy St. Patrick's Day to them as well. Ian, you have some stats for us from last week, I believe.
I certainly do. And a bit of controversy this week.
Oh, really?
Yes, not necessarily a fully agreement from the crowd. As number three, which was Head Turner by Mike Z, which was our song of the week, was best songwriting with 67% of votes, best mix and production with 100% of the votes, but best performance went to White Pigeon and Sea Devil, with Sea Devil song number one.
Really?
With 67% of the votes, yeah.
Well, that is kind of interesting, and we certainly hope that everyone out there keeps voting in that Be a Witness poll that we have up on the site. If you're not familiar or don't know where the site is because you're watching the broadcast at Justin TV or you've downloaded it through one of the many podcast locations where you can get the broadcast, please go to musicsceneinvestigation.com and hit that Be a Witness link off to the right-hand side of the page so you can make your voice heard on the songs that we listen to and review on Music Scene Investigation. Mr. Tom Chianti from New York City. Tom, happy St. Patrick's Day to you.
The same to you, sir, and to all our Irish brethren and sistren.
There are probably five. Maybe five.
You know, it's a happy day for celebrating one's heritage.
True, if you're Irish.
Yeah, well, there's Columbus Day, and I'm sure there's, you know, if you really look at the calendar, there's Byzantine Day and Jose Cuervo Day.
Isn't that a flower? Byzantium.
No, that's Corinthian.
Oh, okay. That was a book in the Bible. Maybe I'm all confused.
Yeah, but they put a flower in the book in the Bible.
I gotcha. I follow you now.
Okay, because I don't know where I lead.
I have no idea. You lost me at and to you. That's where you lost me at. Glad to have you with us, Tom. It's good to see you up and smiling, my friend.
Well, thank you. It's good to be here. I look forward to today's show, and I'm sure a good time will be had by all.
I'm sure it will. Now, Frozen out in the chat room is saying everyone's Irish on St. Patrick's Day. Ian has a rebuttal to that.
No, I have a rebuttal.
Oh, okay. Tom has a rebuttal to that.
Everyone can't be Irish on St. Patrick's Day, because then who's going to drive?
Ba-dum-bum. All right. Thank you, Tom. Our guest panelist today has been on the show numerous times before. We're always glad to have her. Usually when we have her on the broadcast, that's when technical difficulties abound because I push the wrong buttons. Welcome back to the show, will you please? Andrea Bensmiller from the Live to Play Network. Andrea, how you doing?
We haven't had any technical difficulties yet today.
Actually, we have, but we just haven't told anybody about them. So
I'm doing well. Good to see you guys again.
Well, it's good to have you back with us. You've been a busy, busy person while relaxing a little bit over the past number of months, from what I understand.
Yeah, I did a little goofing off these last couple months.
I do. All right, so goofing off by your standard is probably a bit different than my standard. My goofing off is like building mountains out of Jell-O pudding and stuff like that. I'm assuming that you're more productive than I am.
Sorry, did you just admit
well,
that
I don't
live
know about
there?
That. I did get some songwriting done. That was nice, you know, to take some time and do that. That's something I haven't done in a while, so... Always nice to get back into playing and writing.
So you have been busy then. You've actually done something, unlike me, who does nothing. And yes, I did say that live, Ian. So just want to make sure everyone knows that. Now, over on the Live to Play Network, you guys just finished up with a bunch of stuff on NAMM, a bunch of reviews up and all sorts of good stuff out there. But I know that you've taken a breather from a lot of writing. I mean, writing is hard business, right?
You know, the thing about blogging is we had adopted this rule, which was basically all our blogs had to have video, and most of them do still. And so it was a lot of work turning one of those out every week. And then doing reviews on top of that. So yeah, I took a minute to take a break. I kind of ran out of some ideas in December. I just needed a second to to regroup. So, but I'll be going back to them shortly, as soon as I can think of something that people are going to want to read.
Now, I got to say, I miss your video reviews. You've done a number of video reviews. In fact, I think we've ran a couple of them on this broadcast once upon a time. So I'm looking forward to you getting back to those as well.
Yeah, those were always a lot of fun. You know, there's so much new stuff. In this NAMM show, I think they continued on the journey towards iPad development, and certainly the last year was just an explosion of that stuff. So there's a lot of new crazy stuff that's, you know, a lot of fun. So yeah, hopefully I'll be doing some more of that this year, you know, now that I've done a little bit of writing and gotten my goofing off time done, and I'll be by the pool a little bit this summer too, so I won't have a good excuse anymore for putting it off.
I say being by the pool is not a bad thing. Maybe you can do a review by the pool on waterproof music gear. How's that?
But you know what's funny is you could probably record by the pool now on iPad. You know,
true.
So that might be a fun project. Maybe I'll float that by the team.
And I think
I like that float.
You know, why we don't have to be in a studio. It doesn't have to be a lot of work, right?
That's true. That's very true.
You have a Mai Tai and, you know, have the band over, get it all we'll tracked in an afternoon.
Sounds like a plan to me. I'm all for that. Now, you mentioned.
Question.
Okay, go ahead, Ian.
Andrea, you'd agree that music sort of transcends just the music. It sort of extends to image. So is that a new tattoo you've got?
Yes, my tattoo is in progress.
Go on, give us a close up.
Yeah, it's a guardian angel. And the funniest thing anyone has said about it so far is this old man at the gym the other day said to me, "Is that a lion with wings or is it a chicken?" And I said, it's my guardian chicken. So
I mean, you haven't joined a cult or anything, have you?
Oh, no. It took me 10 years to decide to get this. And I finally decided to just do it. And but that's one session. I have two more to go. There'll be color and all that on there. So,
Now, I know that Ian also sports a couple of tattoos. So, nothing quite as elaborate as your guardian angel, though.
No,
yeah, well, you know, when you have 10 years to think about an idea, then, you know, it becomes kind of big. So, and I had a great artist to work with, and so he was like, "Well, let's go big." And I said, "Okay." And how much is that going to cost?
He twisted your arm, in other words, yeah.
He did. He did, but he's good at what he does. So, you know, it's not hard to give money to artists that are really amazing, you know.
Right. Absolutely. You've been teaching during your kind of working hiatus, if you want to call it that. Again, you work harder than I do when I'm relaxing. I can give you lessons on relaxing, by the way.
I could probably use those.
Yeah, maybe we can work that out at some point. But you've been doing some teaching, too. I know that you teach guitar, vocals, and what was the other one?
Piano.
Keyboards, piano, of course. I should have known that. So is that something that you do online? Is there some place, if our audience is interested in getting lessons, tutelage from you, that they can go to find that out?
You know, I don't offer really online lessons, but the few of my final blogs from last year were really lessons about theory and piano. So I may pick that up again this year when I get back into the blogging thing and kind of go on that in that direction. It seemed to be something that people liked. So, you know, they can check out Live to Play there. We don't do really lessons, but there are time to time blogs that are about, you know, instrumental, you know, little tricks and tips and stuff like that. So,
all right. Well, that's good. I appreciate that. And you said, now I got to ask this question because I thought the answer prior to the broadcast was kind of funny and kind of interesting. The reason why most of your students are coming to you looking for specifically for vocal lessons is what?
Everybody wants to be on American Idol.
Why now? I got to seriously ask the question. Why are so many people infatuated with the kind of abuse that probably 90% of the vocalists who appear on American Idol and shows like it have to put up with?
You know, I think what's funny about this whole trend right now is, and I actually kind of like it because, you know, guitar players had their era where that's all really everybody cared about. And now it's kind of like the vocalists' moment. And you know, it is definitely a chance to get heard and be seen. And you know, there aren't a lot of those out there right now. I mean, we don't have a record industry the way we used to, where you just do your time and get really good and could get a label deal and maybe get somewhere. It's a lot harder to do that. So I think for the vocalists, this is it really does feel like an opportunity, even if you're going to get slammed for it, you know. So, you know, there it's kind of like a moment in the sun right now, and if they can, I tell my students, if you know, if you want to shoot for it, go for it. You know, there's nothing getting in your way if you really try hard enough and you're good enough, you know.
I guess no guts, no glory.
No, exactly. One of my favorite mottos is go big or go home. You know, if you're going to try for it, try, go for it. You know, there's nothing worse than regretting not giving it your all. So
I have to agree with you on that 100%. So I got to ask this question as well. We know that you've had the hiatus, the working hiatus. See, you put me to shame here. That's all I can say. The working hiatus, I assume that there's an end in sight. What do you got coming up? What do you got going on? The big thing coming up in the Vegas area, I think, is the new South by Southwest extension, more west than south this time around. So what's coming up for you in the number of months ahead?
I think, you know, well, anything that happens in Vegas, we definitely cover largely. So I'm sure I will probably be at South by Southwest checking out that. I'm really into covering the music part now. We added a couple people at Live to Play who are also gear techie people. So that took a little bit of the pressure off of me doing mostly gear. So it's nice to maybe think about this year going out and really covering music, you know, who's out there and what they're doing and, you know, styles and trends and stuff like that. So I think I really want to focus on that this year.
That's good. That's a good starting point. I if I can make a suggestion.
What's that?
Keep an eye on this guy I know. He's an Italian guy. He's not a young pup anymore, but he's still got a little bit of movement left in him. His name is his last name is Chianti. first name Tom. Now you can recognize him because of the beard that he had. I happen to have a picture here. And you can recognize him because of the beard and the balding head. But don't let that fool you. He's a wild guy, and I understand he is going to start singing sometime.
Well, I can't wait to hear that.
I'm going to contact Andrea and see if we can get some sort of vocal lessons going. I'm sure she's very good. Excellent, as a matter of fact. And I will even put a little clause in there that states if I win American Idol, she gets a piece of the act.
There you go. You can't beat that.
Excellent. Look, I'm going to vote you through just to see you get to the final, Tom, to be honest.
I'm on board, Tommy.
Yeah, I mean, I believe fair is fair.
Oh, there
you go. I think it's a new campaign for MSI, Tom Chianti for American Idol.
And we're going to have to do something because as the Iron Saul has said out in the chat room, you know, he'll have to dye his beard because I think there is an age limit on American Idol. I'm not sure what it is anymore, but
pink. I think I've passed it by twice over.
Maybe, but America's
always
Got Talent.
Yeah, there's always that, or The Voice, Tommy. I mean, you know,
that's
I
true.
Was thinking more of the face.
Dream big.
Yeah, dream big or go home, Tom. That's all we're saying. All right,
I really appreciate all the encouragement from the chat and my associates here. And one of these days I will break out into a song or a rash and it'll be there for all to see.
See, I told you it was
already
a picture.
It's already there for everyone to see. They've only got to check out I'm a Big Head.
That's true. That's very true. All right, speaking of dreams, let's see if we can make some dreams come true on today's Music Scene Investigation by listening to some music that have been submitted by artists from around the world. If you're ready, I'm ready. I know you are. So let's go ahead and take a listen to song number one on today's Music Scene Investigation. Here it is, everyone, song number one.
That makes some folks uncomfortable, but I don't give a dang. If you can't can't say nothing good, don't say nothing at all. That might be proper thinking, y'all, but that ain't how I roll. So I'm gonna speak my mind, gonna lay it on the line. I'm a backbone, strong, straight shooting, tell the truth or every time. I wanna shut my mouth, but I'm gonna go ahead, cause sometimes some things need to be said. Democrat, ain't no Republican, ain't giving them my money, hell, they don't get nothing done. People making millions, TV preaching and playing ball, and we can't pay our teachers, man, that drives me up the wall. So I'm gonna speak my mind, gonna lay it on the line. I'm a backbone, strong, straight shooting, tell the truth of every time. I ought to shut my mouth, but I'm gonna. Likes to keep it to yourself, always watching what you say instead of offending someone else. That'll sure make you friends but leave you all bottled up. Call a spade until you win, enough's enough. So I'm gonna speak my mind, gonna lay it on the line. I'm a backbone strong, straight shooter, tell the truth through every time. I'll shut my mouth, but I'm gonna go ahead, cause sometimes some things need to be said. Oh, yes.
Song number one on today's music scene investigation. Let's go straight over to Ian, find out what he thought. Ian?
It's groovy, it's sleazy, it's cynical. I love it. Quite simple. I mean... strong mix. I'm not going to say much about the mix at all. The vocals well placed for a change and very well recorded. I could hear everything nicely. Nice use of organ and piano sort of playing off each other. You know, the guitars are well placed, sound good. Everything's just sitting nicely in this. It really is nice to hear such a professional recording. Performances are all strong. The groove there, I mean, it just got me smiling. The lyrics were pretty good from what I can remember. You know, gonna speak my mind. I think it's, you know, from a lyrical point of view, it's very current. It's got a lot of poignancy to what's happening in the world at the moment, which is good. But the arrangement was there, the storytelling was there, the mix and the production and the performances was there. I can't really say anything bad about this. This is a good, strong, soulful country tune.
All right. Well, I appreciate that, Ian. Thank you. Over to Tom Chianti. Tom, what do you think?
Well, on the other hand, no. I have to agree with Ian. I mean, this is a band I would actually go to see live and probably, you know, get up dancing with my cane. Put them on stage. Surround them with a cage and throw your beer bottles at them. Well sung, well mixed, well performed, up-tempo, catchy. The only thing I missed, really, was a saxophone or a horn section. I mean, they had enough going on, but with this type, you know, just a little baritone sax. Baritone sax.
Baritone, met him once. He's a nice fellow.
Yeah, he is. It's all positive on this. I do think it would, be very hard to find a commercial market, but it's a classic style of music done very, very well.
All right, Tom, I appreciate that. Thank you very much, Miss Andrea Bensmiller from the Live to Play Network, Redbox.com, her personal site. Andrea, what do you think?
This is going to be so easy. Because I loved it. I loved it. It was so well done. Like Ian said, it just made me happy. And you guys know how critical I can be of everything under the sun. But nice voice, great vocals. This is one of those kind of classic bluesy country tunes that it's totally radio ready. The mix was great, great. Love the organ, love the piano, and the solo broken up between the piano and the guitar. Really classily done. Very nice. Nice bridge and turnaround in the bridge. Just kind of perfectly written. Love the hook. It's one of those, smart ass country lines that is just perfect. It's smart. It's a little bit funny. It's catchy, and it's just one of those songs that I would go out and definitely buy this, and if it was on the radio, it wouldn't shock me at all that it had found a place, because it's really just so pro, and I like everybody else, I don't have a single thing to say to improve on it.
All right. Well, I appreciate your thoughts. Thank you so much. The name of that track is called Some Things. It's by David St. Romain. David St. Romain with Some Things. We appreciate your sending that track in to Music Scene Investigation. Thanks so much. All right. Before we get to our second track, just want to remind everybody that coming back soon, you know them, you love them. Carol and Mark at Butterflies Radio with Twitter Tuesday Live. If you're they've been gone for about a month now. So they'll be back sometime the end of next month or the beginning of the month after that. Looking forward to having them back at butterfliesradio.com. And also you'll be able to hear Twitter Tuesday Live, of course, on MSI Radio as well. Ladies, gentlemen, we have track number 2 coming our way right now. Are you ready for it?
Mm-hmm.
I thought mm-hmm. you might.
No, I'm not. No,
you're not. We'll give you a second, Ian. Go ahead.
Yeah, we're good to go. Let's play.
All right, here it is. Track number 2 on today's Music Scene Investigation. Enjoy it, everyone. They say the air That's track number two on today's MSI. Let's go over to Mr. Tom Chianti, find out what he thought about this particular track. Tom?
Hi, Rich. How are you?
I'm doing fine, Tom.
This song has potential. There's a lot of good musicianship, but the guitar sound is, the whole mix is lacking fullness and bottom. The guitar sound just grating and way up too loud in the mix. I think there was a good drum sound, but you couldn't hear it. And the vocals and the background vocals got buried by the guitars. In some of the verses, the bass, they panned stereo to try to give the guitars some bottom, but that didn't leave anything because the drums were so buried, there was no bottom in the middle to focus it. The vocal performance was well done from what I could hear. It's a little crowded. Like I said, there's potential here. But, don't let the guitarist mix. And what else? The guitar sound. And like 3.5 minutes in, there was like something, everything got a little bit louder and then dropped back down again. I didn't like that. And it was structured okay. But again, the guitars just are ripping through the mix. They're too bright. They're hashy. This mix is compressed a little bit too much. There's no breathing space. And the drums, like I said, were played well, but you could barely hear them.
All right, Tom, I appreciate that. Thank you very much for your thoughts. Over to Andrea. Andrea, what do you think of track number two?
Yeah, I agree with Tommy, and I think he covered the mix part, which I totally agree with everything that he said. I think the musicianship is good. There's obviously some really technical guitar playing from the guitarist. The vocal, I can tell, not a bad vocalist. A little pitchy here and there, but the real problem is I couldn't understand a thing, because it's so buried by everything else. Don't even know what the hook is on this tune. No, not a clue. I think I caught maybe two words, future and something else, as it went by. Just can't get a grip on the song. The melody, what I can tell, is okay. But hard to put together what it actually is as a song. Yeah, I would definitely say potential too. It's not bad. It's just the mix is not doing it any services. And for this style, to me, I guess if we're putting this in the metal hardcore category, the style is somewhat dependent on the voice and the vocalist being kind of badass. Because that's typically what these bands are presenting, other than the shredding guitar playing. So in the power, but that got lost entirely. I can't even really tell whether this vocalist has that because it was so completely drowned out. So yeah, major tweaking on the mix, would be better for sure. But decent. I think the musicianship is there. For sure.
All right. Well, I appreciate it, Andrea. Thank you very much. Over to Ian. Ian, what are your take on track three?
Yeah, I mean, at risk of repeating everyone else's.
Oh, track two. Track two. I'm sorry, yeah.
Well spotted, Tom. You keep taking that coffee.
He's not celebrating St. Patrick's like the rest of us.
But yeah, with the risk of repeating what everyone else has said, I mean, there are some good players here. Loved the twin part solo on the guitars. There's some very good playing there. The shredding, there's a bit of sweet picking there and things like that. Really nice technical stuff going on. But the guitars were too loud, man. I mean, I like loud guitars, but they were just too loud. It was just dominating the whole song. I mean, I'm going to question if those drums were programmed and not played, because there were parts which were fantastically done and parts which just seemed to be very stale and not really grooving with the rest of the song. And the sound to me was like very good drum sounds, but not quite good enough. And they sounded a bit verby and a bit too much in the distance from their own fault of having too much reverb setting them back in the mix. The vocalist, I wasn't convinced by. From what I could hear, again, it was buried. I couldn't get the lyrics properly. But from what I could hear, even his performance wasn't convincing me. You know, there's getting it right and getting it to work in the context of a song, and then there's feeling that song and capturing that feeling of performance, and I don't felt he'd done that for me. There was some nice harmonies coming on the bottom end, but it really did need some higher harmonies and more layering on the vocals to sort of make it bigger. Think of bands like Alice in Chains and another band which sounded very much like them, which I can't think of the name of at the moment. Days of the New, that's the band. And you could have some nice vocal parts going on here, but the vocalist does need to convince me more. Turn the guitarists down, and the bass was just a wash in a mess of bottom end from my point of view, and that mostly supplied by the guitars, which are too loud. An arrangement is there. There's a song there. Can't really tell you much about the lyrics. Vocalist needs to work harder a bit, and the guitarist needs to turn down.
All right, fair enough. Thank you very much, Ian. I appreciate that. The name of this track, track number 2, by the way, it's called Pathway to Hell by Rolling Thunder. We appreciate Rolling Thunder sending that track into Music Scene Investigation. If you or your band want to get your music heard in front of our panel, very easy to do. It's also free all the time, every time. Go to musicsceneinvestigation.com and submit your song. It's up at the top of the page. It's a little button you push up there and sign up and submit your music. And you can submit more than one if you'd like, but only do it one at a time, please. You'll find all the rules and regulations right there. We appreciate you taking the opportunity. All right, guy and gal and guy.
Thank you, okay. And guy.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
And we're not quite sure, to be honest.
Yeah, we've got another track to listen to, so let's please give it a listen while I'm still coherent enough to play it. Here is track number 3, everyone. Hope you enjoy it on this week's Music Scene Investigation.
Take more water with it.
Simple. there what you want it to be. I'm tired of staring at the sky. Are you what you want it to be? I'm tired of staring at the sky.
And there you have track number 3 on today's Music Scene Investigation. Let's go over to Andrea from the Live to Play Network, dregbox.com, to find out what she thinks about this particular track. Andrea, your thoughts?
This one is so interesting. It's got this like kind of 80s vibe. Interesting voice on the vocalist. I thought it was very well recorded. The mix was decent. The bottom was a little boomy, thuddy for me. The kick was a little thuddy. But the balance overall I thought was nice. I didn't find the guitars too overwhelming. And I did like these two parts that they had panned at one point, complementing each other. It's always a really nice way to build your track. To use those pan guitars, you know, rhythm guitars, to do something different than just play straight rhythm. So that was really nice. The melody I thought was a little rambly. I had trouble really kind of honing in on the hook. But the funny thing about this track is that it's got that vibe, and so you don't mind so much that there's not. I wouldn't call it a strong hook. It sounds authentically like that whole, you know, 80s, you know, kind of, it's not totally punk, but it's like a polished punk sound. And that vibe is there. So I think it works. I love the bridge. Really nice. I like the drop, in intensity. I liked the kind of shouted O backing vocals singing in that background. There was like a pre-solo section with a drum solo. I really could have done without that. I'm not a crazy fan of drum solos to begin with. But I just didn't really see the point of that particular section. And then the solo itself, I found the solo, the guitar part of the solo, to be a little bit pointless. Like there wasn't a real strong development of the solo itself. So it didn't really capture my attention that much. It felt like it was just a little random. Nice hits back in though. I thought it's a strong track. It's authentic to the feel of this style. I see it being really successful as one of those tunes you could license to film and TV, you know, for that reason. It sounds, it's, you know, from that era, you know, music that sounds like this might be a little bit expensive. So the people who did this might want to check out some licensing, because I think that you could probably find that for this track. You know, I liked it. There was a lot of solid stuff about it. Some of the musical ideas a little bit not there, but otherwise good.
All right. Well, I appreciate it, Andrea. Thank you very much. Let's go to Mr. Ian Husbands, find out his thoughts. Ian?
Yeah, again, I mean, what a top track. My real criticism of this was the levels. It was really loud, and I think there was a tad of overcompression going on in the mastering there, but otherwise everything sounded great. It's quite a modern thing to overcompress and punch everything up really loudly at the moment. It's not something I necessarily like, and it does take a bit of space out of the track. You just find everything's there in your face, which, you know, for this style of track, which has got that sort of Sum 41, Blink 182, strangely mixed with a touch of Alice Cooper. That's who I reckon the vocalist sounded like. What do you reckon?
Yeah.
Well, who did that song? Mom's All Right, Daddy's All Right. They just seem a little...
Yeah, definitely has that same vibe.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's so punk meets Alice Cooper, which is kind of cool. Because, you know, there was elements of punk in what Alice Cooper done anyway. But that sort of poppy punk. There were some great moments in it. The hooky wah-oh-ohs and stuff like that. But yeah, there was also a couple of moments which were a tad awkward. That drum solo section, as Andrea sort of pointed out. I mean, I don't like drum solos because basically you know that afterwards the bass solo's coming.
Hey now, Ian.
Sorry. but yeah, there was a few awkward moments. But I mean, generally the structure was good. The performances were strong. There's definitely a commercial songwriting thing going on here. And as Andrea said, licensing and stuff like that, or, you know, even a release themselves, I think they could do decently if they got some decent backing behind it.
All right, Ian, I appreciate that. Thank you very much. Over to Tom Chianti. Tom, what do you think?
Thanks to Frozen for reminding me the name of the band. The vocal was very Cheap Trick sounding. And I like the vocal sound. There's a lot of good sounds here. I have a lot of issues with the balances and placement in the mix. The guitars were loud, but the drums were loud. The vocals started, it was uneven. It started off a little buried, and it seemed like the mix didn't really come together and everybody playing together until the end. And there was that one point where at near the end, the drummers just seemed to get a little tired and missed a kick. It was late or something, and he recovered nicely. But there's definitely a well-played, well-structured, well-produced. But it really has to go back to be remixed. To get make it wider, deeper. It was very full sounding, and it was a little crowded for me. Other than that, I mean, I agree with both Ian and Andrea. They picked out the points, but I had a lot of issues with the mix. It could have been done better. And still have kept the power and just add some space to it.
All right, Tom, I appreciate those thoughts as well. Thank you so much. The name of that track is To Be by a group called WakeUpCall. To Be by WakeUpCall. We appreciate their sending that track into Music Scene Investigation as well. All right, y'all have some important business to attend to right now. We have a song of the week to be selected. I'm going to let you talk it out. Decide amongst yourselves and or convince somebody else that you're right and they're wrong, whatever the case might be, and let me know what you think.
I'm going to be the perfect gentleman and go ladies first.
All right, Tom?
I thought he meant you, Rich.
May have. Andrea, what do you think?
You know, I'm so torn. I'm torn between one and three. I tend to look at music now as a, especially for this show, you know, where is the potential for this to go? And knowing that everybody out there who is indie is really trying to get, you know, somewhere. We don't do this so that we can just have our friends listen to it, you know? And both these tracks they're both solid. You know, the first one's a very solid radio ready, could definitely sell it to somebody, you know, giant artist and have a hit song there. And track three, I see as like a really big success in terms of licensing, for film and TV. So they both have so much potential. I'm going to choose number one only really because there really wasn't anything that I could pick out in terms of there being improvement. I thought that musically the track and the ideas in it were so solid. And I don't think I can really say that about number three. It's a great vibe, you know, nicely done, but there were some musical things that I think were a little weaker. So I'm going to go with number one. I'm going to go with the country tune.
Some Things by Dave Romain, or Dave, yeah. St. Romain. All right. Ian and Tom?
Ian, you should continue with ladies first. Go ahead.
I can't hear you, Ian.
That's because, you know, I'm just ignoring that comment with the disdain it deserves.
Oh, all right.
Yeah. They've both got a market, these tracks, one and three, in their own rights. It's a totally different market for both of them, but they've both got a lot of potential. I'm torn as well, to be honest. My heart's telling me number one. Sort of, my head's sort of saying number three. Do I go with the heart? Do I go with the head? I'm going to go and align myself with a young guest for today and go with number one.
All right. So number one, Some Things, David St. Romain again. Tom, what do you think?
I think.
Who cares?
Well, that's not fair.
Tommy always picks whatever Ian and I don't. So
not this time. I have to agree with what you said, Andrea. And as far as what Ian said, both my head and my heart are with number one. Number three is very strong, but I really feel that there are strong mix issues, and the drumming, while very, very well played through most of the song, sort of fell apart a little bit at the end. And number one was solid, top to bottom. And I could, like I said, you know, I don't go out for anything. I'd go out to hear that band.
All right, so there you have it. Song number one, Some Things by David St. Romain, is our song of the week. I appreciate y'all weighing in on this. If you want to get your voice heard out in the audience, go to the Be a Witness page on musicsceneinvestigation.com. And let us know what your thoughts are as well. We'd love to hear from you there, and you can make your voice heard very easily. We'll bring you the results of that poll next week. Andrea, we appreciate you being with us. It's always a pleasure to have you on.
You guys are always so much fun. Thanks for having me.
Quick question, Andrea.
Yeah, sure.
Well, next week's guest is Bill Evans. So anything we should be asking him?
He's digging for dirt, you know this.
Dirtier the better.
Oh, how can I give Bill some grief?
I'll tell you what, put it in an email. I'll make sure we include it in the show.
I will shoot you a couple of key questions that he will, you know, have to dance around.
Excellent. Also, you can give us his home phone number.
Oh, that's true. Yeah, that's true.
All right. Well, we appreciate it, Andrea. Thanks again for being with us. Thanks to everyone out in the chat room for being with us as well. We certainly hope you join us again next time. When, as Ian said, Bill Evans from the Live to Play Network will be joining us, and we'll give him a hard time as appropriate. And so until then, we're going to play out with Some Things by David St. Romain right here on Music Scene Investigation. Thanks, everyone. We appreciate it.
Goodbye.
Bye.
Uncomfortable, but I don't give a dang. If you can't say nothing good, don't say nothing at all. That might be proper thinking, y'all, but that ain't how I roll. So I'm gonna speak my mind, gonna lay it on the line. I'm a backbone, strong, straight shooter, tell the truth every time. I wanna shut my mouth, but I'm gonna go ahead, cause sometimes some things need to be said. Democrat, ain't no Republican, ain't giving them my money, hell, they don't get nothing done. People making millions, TV preaching and playing ball, and we can pay our teachers, man, that drives me up the wall. So I'm gonna speak my mind, gonna lay it on the line. I'm a backbone, strong, straight shooting, tell the truth of every time. I ought to shut my mouth, but I'm gonna. Likes to keep it to yourself, always watching what you say instead of offending someone else. That'll sure make you friends but leave you all bottled up. Call a spade and tell you when enough's enough. So I'm gonna speak my mind, gonna lay it on the line. I'm a backbone strong, straight shooter, tell the truth through every time. I'll shut my mouth, but I'm gonna go ahead, cause sometimes some butt look big.